in chemistry. As I reflect memory, you ride or you die for me. I go to war over you, walk before but by showing you. You know what it is, shout it forever, my little song. As I'm swimming in Benjamin, your shower no limited. You're reminiscing for such a love, know you come back again. I know you can breathe without me, you're gonna need the oxygen. I damn not give you an overdose on my own medicine. I took a sip of your tea and I ain't been right up since. As I think to myself, what it be is a heaven sent. Let's put the past behind us. And go far away where nobody can find us.
Yeah, what's up, y'all? This your girl, Lavern. You're tuned in to Live, Learn with Lavern. Today, I got my homegirls in the building. We go just talk about some real things that's going on in our lives and what's going on in a lot of other females' lives around the O. First of all, deadbeat baby daddies is one of those things. I mean, I think all of us either got a deadbeat baby daddy, got a homegirl that got a deadbeat baby daddy, a family member, something with the deadbeat baby daddy. So, first of all, I got a real deadbeat baby daddy. I mean, for real, I thought I had me a prize, y'all. When I seen him, I was like, oh, yeah, he fine, he this. Man, he ain't worth a dime. So, you know, looks ain't got nothing to do with it. So, you know, don't be fooled by that. For real. So, Cherie, tell me your input on this.
I have two deadbeat baby daddies, and I also have one good baby dad. So, or one good child's father, because he hates to be called a baby dad. He hate it. But yeah, I know a couple homegirls with some deadbeat baby daddies, and like I said, I got two that I can tell you all about.
Well, last month I got $13.22 for child support.
That's not even 3 gallons of gas.
Right, I was mad. I was like, "Are you serious? They could have kept that." But hey, it is what it is. When we have kids, I know I do. When I have kids, I just feel like, you know, I'm in this by myself. If the dad is there, then he's there. Okay, good. Right. The baby daddy, you know, my child's father is there. Mm-hmm. But if he's not, it's not a stress factor to me, because that's what I signed up for when I got pregnant, you know? So it's like, when you have these kids, you expect for these dudes to be there, and 9 times out of 10, they ain't. And that's just like, I know somebody, I ain't gonna say no names, but it's my little homeboy. Now, he got 6 baby mamas. Okay?
6.
And he like 24,
let
right?
Let us pray.
Let us pray. So, he got all these baby mamas. And then he had a baby not too long ago by this one girl. I don't know what made her think. Now, he got all these other kids. What made you think he was going to take care of your little kid? I mean, what made you honestly think that when you see that he's not doing for the rest of those kids? That just killed me right there. So, I'm just like, are you serious?
You know what? You set yourself up for failure when you do that. Period, point blank. That's failure. He had 5 before you.
Right.
And you the 6.
Right.
He ain't doing nothing for that 5th one.
Exactly.
Oh, you the 6th one.
Right.
He dang sure ain't about to do nothing.
Exactly.
For you. You ain't getting nothing.
You ain't getting nothing. You ain't getting nothing. And so I tried it. She really was like, oh, my baby daddy, this, that, and that. And it. Girl, he ain't even bought a pamper to this day. So she feeling. Like I said, she thought she was doing something. You ain't going to be no different.
Well, we all, you know, just to speak on that, we all feel like, I know me personally, because, you know, my daughter's father, is he a dead? Yeah, he a deadbeat. Now, he a deadbeat that make money. So it's not like he's out here just making babies, but he has 2 daughters. And I had to leave that state just to keep myself from going to jail. I'm like, you know what? Before I got pregnant, he was just the best person ever. Mm-hmm. And then once I got pregnant, it was like I saw another side of him that I never thought I would see. Also, I thought because he was raised by two parents and came from a good home, mm-hmm. educated, in the church, thought, oh, he's gonna be this perfect man because he's seen his father. Mm-hmm. But he's total opposite of what I would have met. I should have had a baby by a thug.
Okay, so what's y'all examples of deadbeats? Because some of these guys with kids think that they are really good dads, they really deadbeats.
Let's see, deadbeats. In my eyes. Your daughter texts your daughter text messages you and says, "Daddy, I love you. I want to talk to you. God bless." No call. Deadbeat. Oh, you know what? You can keep your child support this month. Just come and see your daughter. Come and surprise her birthday. You can take my child support and buy yourself a plane ticket. Deadbeat. Didn't send a child support. Didn't get the ticket. That's my example of deadbeat. Not being there for your daughter. Not being there for your child. Not being there mentally, emotionally. You can send all the gifts in the world. But if that child doesn't see you, my daughter's seen her dad since she was in the kindergarten. My daughter going to the fourth grade next year.
Wow.
That's a true deadbeat.
He sends money when it's convenient for him.
Okay, well, you know what? Like, my daughter's that. You know, I got a 5-month-old. And he wants to, like he did the other day, he texting me, calling me, wanting to see me. No, I don't want to see you. You should want to see your child. It's not about me. I don't want to see. And soon when I tell him, no, I don't want to see you, you know, come see your child, I don't hear from him no more. The text is stopped. The phone call stopped. All of that.
He said, you can't mess with the mama, you ain't messing with the child.
Exactly. That's what type of person he is. But guess what?
Got it like before y'all had the baby.
Girl, I don't even want to see his face. That I'm serious. I mean, and then I look at her, I'm reminded every day because she looks just mm-hmm. like him. She mm-hmm. don't even look like me. She looks exactly like him. So I'm like, oh my God. You know, but I love my daughter. I love my daughter to the fullest. I wouldn't trade her for nothing in the world. But he is pitiful and pathetic. And I just can't believe that I chose that. So I can't sit up here and complain and say, this and that. No, I did that. But I got, okay, so Cherie, the thing with you is you have a good husband and your husband is a good father to your children. And, you know, you help with his children. He helped with your children. I love that relationship that you guys have. So what problems do you see and what has been the struggle with you? Because he has other kids.
Right. Yeah.
So what's the struggle that you're having with the other baby mamas or whatever?
Okay, he has one that is like totally, I'm not gonna say worthless, but I feel worthless, like she's worthless.
I'm sleep.
If it's time, he picks his son up every weekend at 7 p.m. on the dot when he gets off of work. He goes there every Friday to get his son. This woman gives him the runaround. He's been doing this for the last 2 years that I've been with him. He said he's been doing it for the last 4 years that they've been broken up. But she gives him the runaround. She drops him off over other people's houses. She won't tell him where he's at. He has to locate his son. And then she will not come to our house at all and drop him off his own residence. She'll take him to the dad's house. She'll take him to the aunt's house. She'll take him everywhere but our house. And then it's like holidays, everything. He's responsible to purchase every single item that this little boy has. And it's like, do you have another parent? Where is the mother? You have him there, but what is your role that you're actually playing in his life? You know, it's like he's doing so much for him and you giving him a hard time, the hard way to go. Christmas, he was supposed to get him like at 3 o'clock in the afternoon on Christmas. We didn't get him till 9 o'clock at night. Christmas was gone. Christmas was over. They are raising their son by text, and it's not because of him, it's because of her.
Do they have a court order in place?
Yeah, they do have a court order. They have joint custody, though.
But is it, like, stipulated that she has to, like, were they ever married?
Yeah, they were married before.
So normally, if you don't apply, you know, if you don't go by the court order, you can be held in contempt.
Well, she goes by the court order. She just drops him off over the aunt house, the dad house, somebody's house where he has to go locate him. He'll be on the interstate going to her house.
And then also she calls and say, oh, we're not there.
Yeah, we're not there. So he got to turn around or he got to wait hours for her to get back home.
So what do you think the issue, though, is? I mean, is it that, is she upset with the fact that, you know, they're not. I mean, because a lot of the time when a female does that, it really has to do with them really wanting to be in a relationship with that person, you know, still, or it's still feelings there, or they still have animosity. Something had to happen. I mean, why would she just be doing, because me, I wouldn't care. Oh, you want your baby? I'll be more than happy to be like, okay.
Or let me drop him off.
I'm going to bring him to you. I'm going to bring this kid to you right now.
Keon, we talk about this all the time. We don't know what her issue is. He carries him on his insurance. Like I said, he is dang near the sole provider for him. He gets him every weekend. Not one weekend goes by unless she specifies, I'm going to keep him here because I got some family in town or something. He gets him every single weekend. Now, I wish I had a baby daddy. Well, he is my other baby daddy. But before that, with my other two, I wish they dads would. I would call, one of them is incarcerated. Well, both of them incarcerated in jail at this point. But one of them was incarcerated for 8 years. He got out for 1 year. And every weekend, get my child? No. He maybe saw my child maybe 40% of the time that he was out for that year. Wow. The other 60, she couldn't find him. She had to locate him. She had to track him down. She didn't even have his number for 2 whole months.
And you know what? Another thing I don't like is when you have a kid and you are in another relationship with somebody, you got time to pick their kids up from school. Exactly. You got time to drop their kid off.
Yeah.
To go to events with their mama. But you ain't doing nothing with your own.
Girl,
let me tell you something. That don't make no sense. And I'm serious. I don't want my baby daddy. I don't even like him. So therefore, it's nothing that, you know. But if I seen that, and you ain't even doing nothing with your own kid, oh yeah, it's gonna be some problems. I'm serious. I don't like stuff like that. And another thing, now that I gotta get on this subject.
Uh-oh.
It's this local dude, right? It's this local dude. I ain't gonna say his name because I did used to like him. I did. He was cool. He was cool.
Can we pray?
But now, let us pray. Mm-hmm. Okay, this dude was a cool cat. I really liked him. But when I've been hearing this stuff lately, hearing this stuff that he been doing, I don't like him no more. And he know I don't like him because I on Facebook, you know how that Facebook is. I made a status yesterday about the dude. And dude must have seen the status. Now, he didn't like the status. He didn't comment on the status. He didn't say nothing. But the next status I made, he liked it, that status, because it wasn't about him. So I know he seen that previous status. So I was talking about how these men can have a wife at home, a girlfriend. You ain't even got to be a wife. The girlfriend, whatever. And you out here having unprotected sex with other women for you to be able to produce another baby. So, this is what he did. Not one time, because the girl got a baby that's a year and something.
Mm-hmm.
But 2 times. She got a baby now that's 6 months by this same married man.
Girl, I just flatlined.
By this same married man. Do you hear me? So, my thing is this. And he got a wife. And the wife is a lovely woman. She has held it down, but she's a lovely fool, too. Because guess what? He's not. He out here sleeping with other people. You don't know who the person that he's sleeping with. Now, if you his wife, you at home all comfortable, thinking you got a husband at home.
No, most likely when she at work.
Yeah, he out here doing whatever he's doing. And so my thing
making
was this, making babies. All I gotta say is this. And hey, when I say this, I don't care who get mad. I'm keeping it so 100. Y'all know how I am. So y'all can get mad if y'all want to. Hands on, keep your hands off. Keep your hands off of people. You running around here, you having babies by other people.
Oh my God.
Girl, I had to say it. I couldn't hold it in no more. I don't care if y'all get mad. It's the truth. People, and then not even on that, this is a young girl that he had a baby by. She's young. And this girl is out here struggling. She had another baby before she had these other two.
Okay, now let me say something on that one.
You want to have these babies?
Nope. Boom. Nope. We can't blame him, though, because, again, Omaha has one of the highest STD rates.
Right, yes.
Now, if you out here, excuse my language, letting somebody raw dog you.
Right.
And you know that this person is married, that says something for you.
Okay.
Now, number one, you did it once. Shame on you, you know. Right. You did it one time.
You're right.
But then you went back again?
Right.
Come on now.
Okay.
Come on.
I feel, no, close listen. Legs
to okay, me. How do you feel close about women men. Messing with married men, though?
Okay, listen. Oh. I done done that before, so I can't sit up here and say, you know, she wrong, she wrong. It's wrong, it's wrong. But guess
who's
what?
Let me tell you.
But listen,
is
though.
Man or is
we
woman?
All make, listen, it's both of them. Because guess what? I don't owe that wife nothing. I'm not sleeping with you. Your husband is who owe you something. Your husband is the one that you made the vows to. He should be the one to say, no, I don't want to do this or I can't do this. Now, let me tell you, I was on the other side of it.
Mm-hmm.
My husband. Okay, my husband cheated on me with the black, ugly, gremlin Janae. He cheated on me with her. Now, you know, I'm thinking I'm all good now. All she used to be like,
this girl, Gion, is a fool. Girl, I ain't gonna lie, LaVern, you a fool.
What do you refer to her? How do you refer to her on Facebook, though? Her name's not really that. What's her name on Facebook, though?
Her name troll? Is, yeah, she's a troll. You know I be saying all type of stuff.
Yeah,
I,
this troll.
Depends, right, it depends on what mood I am. But she's so black and ugly. And I told him, I said, you know what? For you to sit up there and do that, you disrespecting me to the fullest. He calls and texts me, just did the other day, and I said, you know what, where your gremlin at? Where little Whoopi at? Go to Whoopi. Don't come calling my phone trying to get with me, because it'll never happen. I don't want nothing Whoopi. To do with him, and I'm serious. I don't want nothing to do with him. So, because you know what, I felt like I was so disrespected. This was the person that you cheated on me with, and then after me and you was trying to work things out, you went back and continually messing with her. Now, what kind of person would I be to keep on tolerating that? That's just like old boy's wife. She's a fool. I love myself enough to say, hey, I'm not going to risk getting no diseases and all that. The way y'all running around here in Omaha sleeping with all these different people, honey, please, I will not put myself in that position. I promise you I won't. I've been celibate now for a whole year. I'm proud of myself.
Ooh, kudos.
Yes, I'm proud of myself, and ain't nobody, my stuff is on lock, and I don't care. I ain't nobody getting this. So I'm sick, but I did meet somebody though, and I did meet somebody though. He cool.
How was your date last night?
Girl, you know, it was cool. It was cool. You know, he cool. He cute. He mm-hmm. real cute. Mm-hmm. And looks ain't got nothing to do with it, but he mm-hmm. real cute.
Uh-huh.
And he seemed real cool. And we go just see how things go. But I ain't even about to reveal who he is, because I'm going to tell you something.
They going to be on Facebook.
Aren't you engaged? Aren't you engaged?
You know what?
What is going on with that, though?
Listen, I'm semi-engaged, okay?
What's semi-engaged?
I'm going to tell you. I was, you know, this
Give
is the thing.
Give me the definition, please.
I had somebody that I was in a relationship with years ago, mm-hmm. like 5 years ago. And so he came back in my life, and he was like, you know, I love you. He know I'm celibate. And he was like, you know, I want to marry you, all this. I plan on not having sex until marriage. But, oh boy, I don't know. He might have to get it. I'm serious. No, I'm just playing. I'm just playing. But, you know, I just decided that, you know, he asked me to marry him. I said, yeah. And now it's like, I don't know. I'm trying to really find myself. When you've been in relationship after relationship and you have not let yourself get a chance to heal, then you tend to bring your previous relationships and experiences into mm-hmm. the next relationship. Mm-hmm. I don't want to do that. I want to be in a I don't feel like I've ever been in a healthy relationship and a healthy marriage. So therefore, I want to be in a healthy relationship, so I'm going to take things slow. And this guy, you know, I met him, and I think that he's real cool. You know, I could sit on the phone with him for hours, and, you know.
How long you been knowing him?
How old is he? Sit on the phone for hours.
You acting like you in love. You know what I'm saying?
No.
I mean,
only people sit on the phone for hours. A little tender on this.
We got good conversation and everything. You know, everything is cool. I'm taking things slowly, and mm-hmm. he's probably listening right now. If you listening, what's up, boo? I was talking to him before I came in here, so he know who he is. But I'm not letting nobody know who he is. I'm telling you, when y'all see us, then y'all know, because I'm telling you, y'all know how these vultures is. These females is like, keep
they
it real.
Thirsty, they dehydrated. The old y'all, right. I'm going to tell y'all like this. Leave my husband alone. This is a Sharicecape talking. Leave my husband, Gerard Christian, alone. Don't touch him. Don't smile at him. Don't do none of that. When you pull up to the gas station,
delete yourself off Facebook.
Right. When you see him running around, just keep it moving. Because I'm going to be on your...
You is dragging. Now, for real. Now, that's what I'm saying.
No, I'm just playing, y'all.
Okay, because you know you trust your husband and y'all relationship. And see, if you don't have trust in a relationship, mm-hmm. then you don't have nothing. So, therefore, I'm working on trust. Like, I don't trust no man. Mm-hmm. I don't trust him to go to the gas station. And that's the issue that I'm going to have to deal with. Yeah. That's not an issue of him, because I've been in so many hurt and damaged relationships that I just don't trust. Mm-hmm. So, it don't have anything to do with that individual. He could be doing everything right. It's me. Mm-hmm. And that's why I think that in a lot of my relationships, they was messed up because of my insecurities and because I done been hurt so much. So you have to take things slowly, and that's what I'm doing right now. And everything is going to be all good. So, but these females are so thirsty out here, girl. I'm telling you, when they find out that you sleep, that you messing with somebody, you talking to somebody, dating mm-hmm. somebody, whatever, they will do anything in their power to try to sabotage that.
Okay.
And don't let them have a little bit of money, because they going for them. They coming for them.
They going for the broke one. So just imagine what they going to do if they think they got a...
Text time is over. But no, I had an incident where my insecurity got the best of me. For the first time, I can say, first time in maybe 10 years, I just saw this little female, like, smiling off of my dude's face. I said, look here, she's cheesing a little bit too hard for me. So, you know, Monday, I said, I need to find out who she is. But I knew who her friend was, so I called her friend. What's up with your homegirl up in my dude's face like that? She was like, huh, ain't nothing going on. And I said, oh, you show us up in his face. So then I said, okay, you know, whatever, left it alone. She must have called him. She found his number and called him at work. And first she pretended like it was a business call. But then she went to go ahead and went in trying to down me. Mm-hmm. But see, he never came and told me. He never told me about it. Because he's like, I figured, you know, she ain't nobody. But then me and her bumped into each other at the library. She called me on my name. I was like, why has this girl got some beef with me? I'm like, do I know you? I don't know you like that, you know? So I called him. I was like, remember that girl I told you about? Right. He was like, yeah, she called me at work. I'm like, oh, for real? Girl, it came out. She didn't like me because her little ugly kid jumped on my daughter, on my niece and my daughter on the bus. So this was her issue because I went to her mama house. See, I didn't know. I thought she was trying to get my man. No, her beef with me is because I went to her mama house and told up her mama, look, your kid ain't going to be jumping on my kids.
Breaking Look, glasses, it gets real up in here. We call kids ugly.
Yeah. Right.
But they was calling my kid names and stuff on the bus, you know. But I did feel bad for going at her mom like that, you know. I apologize, you know. I was like, you know, I was kind of wrong because that is my elder. I should have respected her. But again, you need to get your bad kids.
Okay, but tell me this. Ain't your man like 60?
No, he's not 60, boo.
How old is he?
Boo.
How old is
he? Boo. He's 56. Okay. Don't you ever. Ooh.
Round it off to the nearest. That's 60. Okay, so are you now? With that being said, let me ask you this, because I, for one, like younger guys. I do. I like my friend now. He 28.
Baby daddy.
So my baby daddy. He 28. I like younger dudes.
I can't do the young ones no more.
What's the difference? Like, I've never dated an older guy before.
Okay. The difference is you have the younger guys where you have like the youngest guy I dated was like 26. You know, you have those feel like, oh, they got the club, they can call you and kick it, but they don't want to, that's all they want to do is call you when they leave the club.
Yeah.
With an older guy, it's like, he called me 10 o'clock in the morning. Hey, boo, what you doing? Nothing. Hey, let's go to the movies. Okay. We gonna go to breakfast. Mm-hmm. We're going to go to the movies, and then most likely we're going to go to dinner. We're not doing no, it ain't no just the movies and go home, no. And once a month, we go get couples massages together. That's our thing. Mm-hmm. And we take a whole day. We go to the movies first or the movies after. We go to dinner. Things we do, we go on dates.
Right.
We have a date night. Even if it's simple, let's go watch a movie at home. Let's go here. Let's go there. We do things together. These younger dudes, they so scared to be out in public with you because they don't know, they messing with so many different women.
Right.
They scared they going to get caught up.
Yeah.
Then, you got the ones who don't even want to pay. Oh, forget that. I just had a problem. I ain't paying for nothing. Now, when I go out with him, if I feel like I want to pay, then I pay.
Exactly.
Because I know that he's going to take care of me. And he's going to do the same thing. And we enjoy ourselves. We have fun. These little young ones, I have more fun with him than I have with a dang 20-year-old.
That's what's up. You know what? That's good. And then, like you said about the pan part. Okay, so this is another thing, right? Okay, so, you know, I just met this dude, right? So, my thing is this. Y'all know how I like to look nice. If I'm dating somebody or whatever, I want them to, they got to be up to par. Now, so far, every time I've seen him, he done been on point, you know, looking nice. If I see some shoes that's ran over, it's going to be over. I'm telling you, I'm not going to want to, I don't know why I'm like that. And that's another thing. He is keeping my interest because I'm telling you, it'll be in a couple days. I'll be like, nah, I don't want to talk to this person no more. I'm not going to talk to this person no more. I get in my feelings like that sometimes. They could say something or do something that's just going to make, just turn me off. I got
a question.
Off.
Do he have a job?
Yes, he does.
Okay, that's a plus.
Yes,
that's
he does.
He got a car?
Okay. Yes, he does.
He don't live at home, do he?
No, he don't.
Okay.
How many kids he got?
None.
This is the crazy part
can
about it.
Can he have kids?
Yeah, that's what I said.
Because he be in Omaha, he got no kids.
All right. That's the thing. That's why our mind frames is so messed up, because we so used to him not having a car, or if he do got a car, it ain't his. He driving some other female car. That's my baby daddy. He running around here driving in another woman car that say grandma on the plate. Who does that? But anyway.
With a handicapped sticker on the
But well, anyway, he don't have no kids. So I'm like, are you serious? He like, no, I ain't got no kids. That shocked me. But see, this is the thing, y'all. He was in a relationship with this woman that he was with for a long time. Like, a long time. Like, since he was in high school, from like 19 to like 20. For like 9 years, he was with this chick for 8 years or whatever. So they didn't ever have no kids. So he's been in a relationship all this time. So I don't want to just come in trying to trap the man down and all that. You know
what
I'm saying?
But if he's been in a relationship that long, has he had time to heal? Or is he just, how long has he been out of this relationship?
For like a year and something.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so okay. Yeah, he didn't have time to heal.
That's good.
And I can heal them wounds. I'll just say, not like that, but boom. You know, I could be a friend to him. So, you know, that's what I'm basically trying to be. You know what I'm saying? He already know I'm celibate. He know there's no sexual anything going on. So, and even though he real cute, you know what I'm saying? I'm very attracted to him. Like, you know, of course he attracted to me. Come on now. Why wouldn't he be? But I just know that I'm just going to have to, if I decide to go have a couple drinks or something, you know what I'm saying? That's when that kick in. Like, you know what I'm saying? When you get in the mood or something like that. So that's going to be my only problem. But other than that, we good. I'm just shocked that he don't have no kids. And I was like, dang, what's wrong with him? You know
no
what I'm
kids,
saying?
No kids. He got a job. He got a car. Don't live at home with his mama. And he good looking.
Right.
Ooh, jackpot.
He ain't gay.
Right. Huh?
He ain't gay, is he?
No.
Because, you know, the download brother is on the ground.
He got all these positives. Yeah, it's like,
what's you know what?
What he been doing under a rock?
Right.
See, that's what I'm saying.
He might be a pretty bug.
Right.
He's a pretty boy.
He's cute.
A grandma.
He got a little thug to him. He ain't got no little room.
You know what? He don't got no tattoos or nothing. Like, I was, it was crazy.
Let us pray. Let us pray for you.
No, I'm not going to pray on that one because he's not. No. But if y'all seen him, though, he not.
But that's good. Well, if you're listening, we not talking about you no more.
No, we not. Because she's excited, so I'm excited for her.
Yeah,
so and that's the part. That's the whole thing. You're supposed to be excited, and then that excitement's supposed to keep on going.
Right.
Mm-hmm. My excitement's been going on from day one, and it's still there.
Okay, how long y'all been together?
6 months.
Okay,
I get pumped.
Good. That's good. That's pumped. A nice thing.
Matter of fact, 6 months Friday.
Okay. Well, I'm hopeful y'all be staying that 6 months from now, but we go, oh, no, let me tell y'all, this is the funny part how I met him, right?
Was you campaigning?
yeah, y'all, make sure y'all vote for Ben Gray. But anyway.
Ben Gray, Mayor Jim Suttle.
Right. Listen, it's funny that you said that because I did. I seen him down there, right? And this is funny, y'all, because y'all know how I am. So I sees him, right? I'm like, dang, he look kind of good. So I'm like, man, let me play it off. So I see him peeping me too. You know what I'm saying? But he don't say nothing. So his homeboy they friends, right? So I was talking to his homeboy, not like on no level like that, but you know, I had talked to his homeboy a couple of times on the phone.
You didn't smash the homie, did you?
No. I didn't smash the homie, but I was talking to him, right, on the phone and stuff. And I was texting him and everything. We was texting back and forth. Well, once I seen old boy, I was like, oh, nah, old boy. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, nah, I don't want to talk to him no more.
You played the old switcheroo.
Well, hey.
Your homeboy cuter than you.
Right. Hey, people do it all the time. So I said.
Yeah, but they don't make it known.
Listen, this is funny what I did. I called old boy. I'm like, hey.
You know we live on air and he might be listening.
I know he probably
you call
is
him
listening.
Say, who's your homeboy?
What's up, y'all? Both of y'all. So listen, I'm like this. This is so funny. I said, I call a boy, the one that I was talking to. I said, hey, my homegirl want to get at your homeboy. Well, you know the whole time is me wanting to get at the homeboy. But I didn't want to just say that. You know what I'm saying? That was rude to just say that. So anyway, make a long story short, I slid on in there and you know, had somebody give him my number, and of course he called, and the rest is history. You know what I'm saying? Oh boy, he got a girlfriend.
Hello,
you know what I'm
yeah.
saying? So why would I waste my time True. On you anyway? True. And you got a girlfriend. Don't nobody got time for that. So I just said, okay, bye, beat it, and that's it. So now
I like
the friend.
I like your friend.
Yeah, so that's what it is.
You are funny.
But yeah, so what else is going on?
A little bit of everything.
We got a girls. Oh, we doing a little girls thing. Tell them what we doing at your house Friday.
Friday 9 p.m. We having a chick pick, one night only slumber party at my house, and I've invited 12 ladies to come and spend the night, and we're going to rock out in our PJs. We're going to have food. We're going to have wine. We're going to have
Zumba.
Shots, Mary Kay facials. We getting up games, and then we getting up in the morning, and we doing Zumba with my friend / sister, Angelique Roseman, Zumba instructor. We about to do this.
Yeah, we about to have fun. I have not done something like that in a long time. I really don't like females too much, so therefore.
So I done had a dragger.
Yeah,
I'm dragging
so
her.
She's basically dragging me like, okay,
you gonna
so
come support
you
me.
You go do this.
Like she gonna come support me.
Right, and so that's the reason why I'm doing it is because she supports me in everything that I do.
Mm-hmm.
And as some people might know, they still be tripping off the fact that me and Cherie is friends now, because me and her used to have issues a while back.
But that's showing maturity.
Right.
That's showing
exactly.
grown women.
Exactly.
And it's always good to have some good, grown, strong
right.
females in your corner, because if you don't, who you got?
Exactly.
Haters.
So, right. So we are just like, just good. You know what I'm saying?
That's
we talk
cool.
about everything. We have a lot in common. And so I'm happy that we did become friends and we did get to know one another. And it's just a good relationship. So I'm just going to go to this little slumber party and see how that goes.
You might meet some more people.
Yeah
she is. She going to meet some more positive people.
It's
I've been
about
hanging
positive.
Around nothing but
yeah.
positive
yeah,
people.
Yeah, me
That's
too.
That's what's up.
Yeah. We've been around, like, we've been going to the empowerment meetings and stuff. We've been around a lot of positive people. You know, I went today and I met with Tila Mickles, and we sat down and talked and got a strategy going to certain things that's about to happen. I got a lot of things that I have going on right now. You know, I've been working with Ben Gray, who is a very positive, and he's been supporting me and everything that I'm doing, and I'm working on his campaign, and, you know, Mayor Sutto and everything that he's doing in the black community. And, I just got a lot of stuff going on. And I just think, and another thing, you guys need to really get out there and vote. You know, do you know it was only a 13% turnout? Yeah. That is horrible. I mean, that is bad. That is bad. That's terrible. So we need to get out there and vote. You think that it don't matter what's going on in the community and it's not affecting us? It does. So you really need to get out there and vote. I'm really into this political thing now. I just feel like, you know, I want my kids to be able to have a good future. And I think that it's very important that we get out there and vote and we try to make sure that our futures is secure mm-hmm. as well. So that's very important.
Mm-hmm. And y'all don't forget about old Tony B's Kitty Campus Daycare. I got that in full effect. We full though. So the community been good. Looking out for Tony B's
that's
Kitty Campus.
Good. See now, yeah. Now what we need to look forward to is expanding.
Yes, because
if you're full now, you yeah. feel me? You're uh-huh. full now. If anybody out there has a building that's available that yes. you guys want to donate or you guys want to help out with, she is more than willing to do that. She needs to expand. Yeah. We want to prosper. We want to have things in life. And she's, doing what she needs to do. And, we about goals and careers mm-hmm. and trying to have things. And, that's why I was saying as far as, how I've been doing real good on Facebook, y'all. Keep it real.
Yeah, you've been doing good.
I ain't seen nobody's pictures getting busted out with they mattresses on the floor.
I ain't seen nobody's babies coming up looking like monkeys.
Right. I've been doing real good. I did good.
You've been doing awesome.
I did have one slip up. No, yesterday, I wouldn't even call that a slip up because I didn't say no names. I just said, what I said. And that was it. But I've been doing real good on Facebook. I ain't been tearing nobody up. I want to keep it that way because I am trying to be positive. And I do feel like a lot of those females that I do be arguing with on Facebook, they don't got nothing on me. They don't have nothing to offer. They all going to be arguing, fighting, and doing the same thing next year that they doing now. I don't have time for that. I've elevated myself. I'm on a whole different level now. I've been on a different level. I just was displaying certain type of behaviors that was unacceptable, but I was doing them anyway. Mm-hmm. So, therefore, I feel like now those things are not acceptable at all, and I'm not going to indulge in those negative behaviors any longer. So, what would people say if they see me with the mayor, they see me with Ben, they see me with Tila and all these positive people and all these different role models, but I'm sitting up here arguing and fighting? That's stupid. So I'm not even going now. Let me tell y'all something. I'm trying to be on a whole nother different level, but these females will. See, now that they see me on something else and being positive and all that, that's when they'll come out the woodwork trying to test me. Mm-hmm. And then me being the person that I am, I'm only going to let them do it for so long. And then after that, then I'm just, flip. I don't want to do that. So females out there, if y'all know that y'all don't like me and I don't like you, I don't have no problem really with nobody right now. I feel like right now they can't even touch me. So, why even acknowledge them? Why even any of that? Mm-hmm. So, I'm really trying to put my gloves up. I'm retiring myself as of today. As of today, I've retired myself. I'm not going to fight no more. I'm not doing none of that. I'm sticking to that. But
and
I
you,
will
you
bring
really
them gloves
to.
Out
you,
of retirement.
You're a grown woman now.
Right, I am. But at the same time, I will bring them out of retirement if I have to.
Oh, no, just like Star Jones said today, I will check you. But you don't have to check them in a way where it messes up your character. Because your character speaks volumes.
Right.
And right now you're doing things that people are noticing you.
Right.
They don't say, I see her with, Mayor Suttle. I see her with being great, helping them out, That's where you want to keep it at. You don't want them. Just let them know. Say, hey, I will check you in a way where I'm not going to lay my hands on you.
Right.
But I'm going to check you and I'm going to keep on going.
Right.
But again, like I said, they're testing you. Girl, they got nothing else to do.
No, but no, this is the crazy part. No. This happened a couple weeks ago. This is crazy. I don't think you knew about this. So I'm down on 30th with Ben, right? We down there
was
on 30th.
Was it the day of election day when we was all out there?
Yeah, that day. We down there. Now, I got a lot of enemies. I got a lot of girls that don't like me. But it's a lot of people that won't test me. They won't go there because they know I'm a box at any point in time. I don't care if Obama was there. It's going to go down. I'm there campaigning with Ben. We on the corner, right? I see this girl. And so when I see the chick, me and her already was beefing on Facebook. So I'm like, man, I'm going to have to fight this girl in front of Ben. This is what I'm saying to myself. So my truck is parked right there. So I'm Ben on the other side. So I'm like, man, let me walk over here so Ben can't see behind this truck. Because I knew we was about to fight. So
girl,
I'm
going to fight her on the street
girl,
and then go back to campaigning.
Let me tell you how it happened. It was so stupid. So I'm right there, right?
It gets real in Omaha, Nebraska.
Right, it gets too real. So I'm right here on the side. She come up. She like, yeah, you got a problem with me? I said, look, girl. I said, look at me and look at you. I said, you're like the dirt at the bottom of my shoe. I said, look at you. I said, I'm in a suit right now. I said, I don't have time for this. I said, but what I can do is meet you around the corner. I said, you see me, I'm right here with this city councilman. I said, why would you even try to approach me like this? I said, that go to show me you wasn't raised right. So she was like, me. So look, she was like, well, whatever, what, and she act like she was about to walk away and turn back around and like stole on me, right? So I grabs her by the hair and I'm like, my cousin right there. So I'm like, get this girl. I said, you know what? I'm about to meet you around the corner. So she trying to swing and go all crazy and all this stuff. And I'm like, man, please don't let Ben come over. That's all that was going through my head because I've changed. I don't want this man to see this, you know what I'm saying, this type of behaviors and stuff. He would have kicked me off of that campaign. Why would he want somebody, you know what I'm saying, in his camp that's doing this type of stuff? I mean, it looked really bad. I even had phone calls. It was some people in Burger King that seen it and called me and was like, was that you out there fighting? I'm like, it was not a fight. It was a little scuffle. It wasn't nothing. You know what I'm saying? It was something that I was trying to avoid my hardest because I don't want to be perceived like that any longer. Now, anybody that know me know I'll fight. I'll do all that. Who got to, I look too good to be out here doing all that. Who want to keep on fighting and doing all that? That's stupid to me. So that's what happened. That's a prime example of a person trying to do better, but then your past sometimes will catch up with you.
Yes.
And I feel like that was my past catching up with me at the wrong time.
But so, you handled it like you're supposed to.
Oh, yeah, I did. And then guess what?
So
I
in the past, do you consider yourself the troublemaker? Was you the troublemaker, or did people make trouble with you? Because you've been in a lot of stuff.
No, you know what? No, listen. Hold up. The only
she
reason,
has been in no, a lot, I so lot. I want her right. to address it.
But listen, the troublemaker?
It was always over a dude, okay? It didn't have nothing to you ask a person, why don't you like her? Okay, probably because I took they dude, or I messed with they cousin dude, or I messed with they somebody dude, and they clicked, something like that. It was never nothing. I didn't steal nothing from them. I didn't do nothing to them directly. It always had something to do with a dude, basically. But to wrap that story up, I told Ben I had to do the show that same day. So I went and told Ben. I said, hey, Ben, here. I gave him the sign. I said, I got to go. I was running back across that street to get in my car. I got back and they was gone. Because they knew it was about to go down. I was about to follow. Hey, we about to meet up on the next corner for real. So I called the girl who it was. She was friends with this girl I know. So I called her phone. I'm like, look, hey, tell your homegirl where she at. We need to meet up real quick. Because what she did, you know, I want to handle this right now. The girl like, I'm not about to come and meet you. Okay, but you came down there where I was at, though. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So let's get this over with. But that was childish. You know what I'm saying? I'm too grown. I'm 35 years old. I ain't got time to be doing that. But I'll retire myself, y'all. So leave
me
alone.
She done hung the gloves up.
Right. I done hung them up. Leave me alone. Let me live my life. I want to be happy.
Hey, I just got a text from Cortez Warren. He said, who's in charge of this radio station? We need to start taking some calls. Maybe he wanted to call in, you know, and... And
is
voice
he mad
his
at
opinion
us?
Or something. What I don't know.
Well, hey, thanks
Cortez,
for listening.
We're going to have you call in next week and you can tell us what's on your
well,
mind.
Well, you know what? I think we need to have, this is what I'm thinking, y'all. What y'all think about this? Because, you know, the show is called Live, Learn with Lavern. And I think that I want to have more intelligent, we need to be like The View. You know what I'm saying? I think that we could have a roundabout table discussion every week about different issues that's going on. That's what my idea is.
Oh, I just got a question on Facebook. Do y'all support city council?
Yes, we do.
I mean, who doesn't support the city council regardless who's on there?
We're telling you to get out here and vote. We support city council, and we're supporting being great for city council.
Exactly. Being great. Period, point blank, bottom line.
I just got a comment from Letitia Mitchell. She said, y'all got me cracking up. Let us pray. Hey, Tish.
Yeah, we need to, I think that this is what we gonna do. And you know what? I gotta say this, and I know when I say this, I know, Cherie, you ain't gonna like what I'm about to say,
okay,
but
what you
I gotta
say
this.
Okay.
We had another person that was supposed to be here today. Oh. She didn't show up. See, that's the type of stuff that I don't like. Now, this is my whole thing. She did tell me that she had some other stuff that she had to do, but that she was going to make it. My thing is this. Don't tell me that you're going to do something when you're not going to do it. I don't like people like that. I don't like people that sit up there and they're not a person of their word. Now, it was supposed to be four people right here. I only see three. Now, that I have a problem with that. So, therefore, that person is eliminated. She don't got to worry about it no more because I don't like stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? And if she listening, I'm sorry, but you know, I like you and everything, but you need to be a woman of your word. I don't like stuff like that. I'm not going to bust her out, say her name, none of that.
She text messaged me and said, "Tell me, you better not say, you better be there. Don't right. say you going to come
say
and don't."
You, but see, this is what I'm saying.
She do it to me all the time. Okay, that's but she guess... said I ain't going to like it because she knows she does this to me all the time. If I tell Keon I'm going to be somewhere, it's Keon's like my mama. I better be there. Okay, or but listen, me and Keon about to go at it.
This is the thing, though. This is the whole thing. Quit saying that you're going to do something and you're not going to do it. That's just like, and yeah, she did say, yes. I hate when Cherie does that. Like, she be like, I'm going to be at Zumba, and then I'm at Zumba, and then a half an hour go by, she don't
show up. Oh, my friends can contest to it. I did on New Year's. I was like, you coming? Busy. I was like, I'm coming. I'm dressed. Girl, I was at home in the bed. I wasn't going out.
I be extra busy, though. Sometimes I tell you, though, I'm not going, and you still get mad. So you're going to have to stop doing this, and you're going to have to stop doing that. Hold on. I'm married. I got kids. I got multiple kids. Right. I got five kids.
Okay.
Plus, I'm running a daycare.
I know that. I understand.
You are the Black Brady Bunch.
Girl, tell me about it.
But she needs to hands full. But you still need to. But that I understand that. And see, like, you be like,
you know what? Keon over here talking stuff just because your boss say you can leave at 1:30 because you exactly tired, you
yes and look I got a
we don't got it buddy. Like that
okay but I'm saying you still should make a rant. I don't it's not like I'm telling her this you. At last moment you feel me I'm mm-hmm. telling her this at a time where she has days to know
well,
what's
let's
going
just,
on
let's just do this listen then. Let me
I've
be
been doing
peacemaker.
A lot better
let's just say this now that we say we're gonna you know we want to do this
right
let's just commit to it and then be like look send a message like look I'm gonna be late.
Right. If you go be late, you go be late. But this is my thing. You shouldn't be late. You cannot just go around being late all your life. She was here 15 minutes before
but remember,
she
guys,
was supposed to be
remember,
here.
Guys, if y'all listening, listen. I really ain't got no... I got a job, but
I've
I don't really...
I've been late
got...
all my life, Keon, and I am starting to pick it up, you know.
You are.
I am getting to places on time.
You are.
Places I ain't never been on time.
You are.
I am
good.
Getting there.
She is.
So that's good. So,
you know,
so
I'm working
progress.
On it.
Yes.
Yes.
And
so
I thank you
progress.
For that. I thank you for that because in the beginning, after a while, I was like, you know what? She's starting to get on my nerves. I was like, I'm going to have to just really tell her for real. But then we got it together and she's been going being on time with stuff so I thank you for that I really do but
I have you and my husband to thank for that too because he's military and he's militant about time
oh yeah
and he gets they on are. My butt
you
about
be late,
being
you late
for
church
I'll be late for everything.
Everything.
She gonna be late
I'll
for funeral.
Like,
come on, let me in.
Right,
I'm
right.
Here.
You gotta. I mean, but come on now. We need to start being on
though.
Time. But I really, you know, I really enjoyed us doing this today. I really think it was really good. I think it was a success. We need
same
to get
here.
To the drawing board mm-hmm. and we need to figure out what we go do, how we go do this because I really feel like us having, you know, myself and you ladies and maybe we might could get one more person, four people. But if not,
inboxes if y'all interested.
Yeah, inboxes some topics.
Yeah,
you know, let
then,
us know what you want to
yeah.
hear.
Mm-hmm. And then I don't want to do it. Now, this is the thing. I really don't want to do a call in because I'm going to tell you something. I'm going to tell you
we
why.
Can just, we can
why?
Hit that button.
But wait, listen. Did y'all remember that dude on Channel 23?
I mean, we could flatline them, though. You know, if they call in with something we don't like,
right.
we don't want
somebody,
to flatline.
That man used to do this. They'd call in and say, he pushed that button so fast, I'll be cracking up.
No,
he had them off
I did Channel 22 with Roy Davenport, and I was rolling my eyes, but I was young. Uh-huh. This lady must have said something. I was like, and she's like, call back. Yeah, you see that little yellow girl right there? She rolled her eyes one more time. I'm sitting there like,
Oh, man.
So, y'all done been warned. Don't call in with nothing stupid because you're going to get the end.
Right, right. Now, this is the thing. I remember somebody just told me this because he was like, are you going to do a call in? And I was like, no. I said, because I know how those haters is. They going to be calling in Santa. He was like, well,
if you don't. Phones may not be on if we do it at the middle of the list. We got to get the public opinion, though.
And
that's what, listen to what he said. And this is what made me think about it. He said, well, if you can't have people call in to hear what they saying, then obviously you got something to hide and you don't want to. I said, no, it's not that. I just don't want to hear all the, you know what I'm saying? I don't need nobody. Look. That's another thing, and this is what I told the dude. This is funny. I said, well, I'm not letting nobody know who you is just yet. He gonna say, well, dang, you gonna have me in seclusion? No, it's not that I'm having him in seclusion.
His inbox is gonna be filled, man, with hater aid.
Listen, he don't even have a Facebook.
Oh, well, guess what?
They gone.
Girl, he don't got no Twitter, no LinkedIn, listen, no nothing, because they going to find him.
Listen, I'm keeping him. Listen.
These he vultures, got a phone number.
Y'all ain't got.
They going to get that phone
these
number.
These vultures will find out where he works.
I know. That's what I'm saying. That's why I'm keeping him away. Ain't nobody going to see him. That's the problem I did with my baby daddy. Look, remember when I had put that picture of his body on Facebook? But I didn't put his face on there. I just put his body. You know, because he got a nice body. I just put his body.
Remember, you don't like him.
And then, right, I can't stand him. So, I put that on there, and everybody was like, who is this? Who is this? Soon when I got to be his friend on Facebook, and I made him a Facebook and all that, these females just started coming out of nowhere.
That's when
they found out who he was. They started inboxing him, saying, oh, she this, she that, she used to mess with this person. Okay, I'm not no virgin. So, therefore, why are you telling him this? Whatever I did, that was my past. And that's what I'm trying to get this dude to understand. He like, well, dang, what kind of past do you have? I mean, that's basically like when I tell him, like, look, you know, if people find out, you know, me and you talking, they go, you know, be telling you this and that. He like, well, what, you know, this. I mean, I'm just me. I don't think a lot of people could take certain things that I say and certain things that I do. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So, I think that's the problem. That people just don't know how to handle me or take me.
If it happened before them, period, point blank, they shouldn't be worried about what right. happened before them.
Exactly.
Because we all got passes. We all done did yep. things and messed right. with people we not proud yep. of.
Right.
So, ladies,
I wish
men,
I could take them all
if it happened before you and somebody comes to your inbox or somebody texts you, tell them where to go. And that's the HEL double hockey 6L.
Yeah. Yeah,
go.
Precious wants to get rid of. There's a lot. Well, I shouldn't say a lot.
I wish I could unsleep boy. You. I wish I could. Did you see that on Facebook? They got this thing that was like, I wish I could unsleep you.
I promise you.
Oh, man.
Because if I would have known what I know now, boy, I would be like, I don't even claim some of y'all. I'm going right, to be honest. Right, they'd be like, you talk to him? Nope, I never talked to him.
Right. I don't even know who you talk to. I don't even know him. Mm-mm. For real. It's some of y'all that I wish I would never even looked at.
This and one right now with 7 kids, 4 baby mamas. Still boy, go see somewhere. Get your life. You can't do nothing for me and Taters. Me and Taters is one. This is two of us. You can't do nothing
seven
for us.
Kids,
girl, 7 kids.
Baby mamas.
Oh, baby mamas, girl. What you going? Girl, you can't child support until you 70.
Okay.
I keep my one foot in and my one foot out.
That's a life sentence of child support.
I'm going to tell you. It's some of them that I just don't even want to look at. I'm serious. I hate that I even did it. But, hey, it is what it is. You know, it ain't no changing it. I mean, hey, it is. So, you know what? Now, a good idea is like
put them on blast. Oh,
no, like are you on Facebook now?
Yes, I am on Facebook.
See, because William was doing, you know, the guy that runs the station, yeah, he was saying that like people can go on there and they ask questions. Mm-hmm. They can ask you questions and everything from there.
Mm-hmm. Let me go look and see
and all that. So, but my thing is, I don't want no stupid stuff. People be saying some stupid, people just ignorant.
We can filter the questions.
But
though.
We don't want to just do positive. I mean, hey, if a person want to know, but see, this is the thing. They some cowards. They go know that. They going to think I'm going to go off if I know their name. So they going to probably make a fake page and be like, the questions from there. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. They not going to do it from they self.
No, but you know what? We trying to be like,
listen. Like Jesus took criticism.
Hello.
Right.
We gonna have to take it too.
Right.
I mean,
just like that in Miss Nebraska.
Yes.
Yes. You know that song. You know that song was
one of the biggest superstars out here, and she take mad criticism.
Exactly. So what makes you think that little two That little low budget video you made, Miss Nebraska, that video was so horrible.
Okay, let me just say this real quick. Like what the news people say, any thoughts and views they're saying are not all supported by pressure. I'm just here to listen and here to speak.
And I support that message.
All comments and right. views are not reflected by everybody on this panel.
Right. Then, well, y'all know I feel that way, and I'm going to continue to feel that way. That video is listen, horrible.
I'll stick my middle finger up to you. Yes, I will.
That video. Oh, so wait, y'all. What y'all think? I'm thinking about. Oh, we only got a couple more minutes. I'm thinking about. I'm tired of my braids now. Mm-hmm. Even though they still look good, I'm ready to get them out. I'm ready to start getting my hair done over again every week. I'm tired of the same look. I'm used to getting my hair done every week. But since I work out so much.
You might want to keep your braids.
I want to keep my braids. But see, that I'm not going to get the rest of these pounds off for another, you know, month or two, couple more months. So, but I love getting my hair done every week. I'm tired of this same look. I look the same.
Just, you, I mean.
Okay, so you need to find somebody to do your hair, to do your tresses.
Well, you know what? I think I'm going to go to my, I did inbox Antonia, text her a while ago, and I never even text her back to find out. I think I'm going to just go ahead and go to Corey or that girl Monique Baltimore, because she's supposed to be real mm-hmm. good, too. But I like, only thing about Corey is that he not in the shop, and I like to lean my head back. I need to get the treatment.
Oh, see, I go to, shout out to Tamika Anderson, who does my natural hair. She gives me a massage, and she has one of those little chairs, well, the bowl uh-huh. that moves around with you, so she behind you.
Uh-huh.
I love it. I go in there, I go in there like maybe 5 o'clock. I'm out of here by 7.
Well, I don't want no natural.
It's actually hard to find a good stylist here.
But she do regular hair, too, though. But really,
well, you know what? I'm not going to lie. Antonia, that was my favorite hairdresser in the world. I love it. Oh, I miss her so much. She did. Can't nobody else do my hair like her.
Well, I'm going to need y'all to get it together, then.
Well, I need to do something. I'm going to figure something out because
Antonia,
I'm thinking.
Can you please do Keon hair?
Anybody out there, look, she want that hair done. Now, look, I know people ain't passing up money nowadays now.
Girl, I'm going to tell you something. I need my hair. I really do. But I'm a type of person where I'm not going to kiss nobody but. So I can't be like, please do. I'll go to somebody else.
Okay, well, can I do this before we close out?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Everybody, I know Cherie's having her thing on Friday. But, guys, do not forget the Omega Gospel Fest on Friday, 7 o'clock at Salem. Come out, support. It is a free event. Donations during, you know, when they pass the plate. If they pass the plate still. Yeah, whatever. But, you know, just donations, but come out and support. Miguel, I shout you. I just want to let you know I'm there for you. So.
Oh, do y'all got any shout outs before we get out of here?
I
got
to shout my husband, Gerard Christian. My
hey,
kids.
Gerard. Hey, kid.
Raven, Gerard, hey. Alea, Nivea, and Jackson. And then I just want to let y'all know, don't forget, May 19th, Be the Gift. It's for at the Memorial Park. It's for all fathers. We call it all fathers out there. Be the gift to your kids. Come on out there and support us.
Yes.
I'm just going to shout out my family, my baby girl, Taylor, all my friends. They know who they are, my little crew. That's about it.
And I just want to give a shout out to my family, my friends. There's too many of them to just say. And let me see. Make sure y'all vote for Ben Gray and Mayor Settle, because that woman, if she get in there, y'all history. We threw Dylan.
Her name is Jean.
Jean Stoffer. Is it Stoffer? Yeah,
like
whatever
that.
Her last name. Jean. That's what you need
mean
to know.
Jean. That's what
mean
I heard they
Jean,
call her.
Honey. Mean y'all, Jean. Y'all better be careful. She ain't no joke. So if she get in office, we might as well cancel Christmas. And then I'm telling y'all right now.
Just
and
like
then,
y'all got out there for Obama because y'all didn't want y'all food stamps.
Right.
Y'all
right.
better get out there for
right, exactly. Y'all better get out there for Jim. Oh, and then we about to get ready. Oh, if y'all want to meet us, we about to go to Hip Hop Aerobics down there at the YMCA on Ames. We about to go get it in.
I'm not dressed to go
Don't forget Tony B's kids rock, baby.
Oh, and then I want to say, hey, boo, I'm about to call you soon when I get out of here.
To see
if you listen to the show. And I put all the business out. See, that's another thing he might not like because, you know, I tell all the business. I mean, it's certain, since he under wraps, I ain't gonna tell that business, but you know I tell
just
the business.
Just don't get that name.
Remember, guys. I ain't saying that name, girl, please.
Remember, guys, to send us your topics. I mean, inbox us, do something. Oh, we'll yeah, let us know,
yeah. So I'm Therese Gave, Precious McKesson, and we're Lavern. Here with Lavern.
Yeah, so we need to do that. We need to do it because Precious is good with that. So, therefore, you can inbox us with different topics and everything. And, yeah, we gonna be here every Tuesday from 5 to 6, and
don't be driving by here thinking that y'all gonna come in here.
Live,
love, learn with
Lavern. Okay, live, love, learn with Lavern. We out. We love y'all, Omaha, Nebraska.
Thank you for listening.
Deuces. We out.
Okay, y'all. You
turn it off?
No. Oh. William.
Can you come turn it off?
We just are going still. This my mama calling.
You didn't I say the show?
Mm-hmm. Hello.
Yeah, did you turn it off?